you, ladies and gentlemen, for coming to the fifth annual meeting of the Clinton Global Initiative. I'm going to be very brief today.
Now it's time for the commitments. I'm very excited to announce that water.org will extend its work to Haiti. We will report on that. And having suffered four devastating hurricanes last year, Haiti is in dire need of more effective and sustainable solutions that will guarantee its population has access to some of life's most basic necessities. Currently, only 51% of rural residents have access to safe drinking water, while only 29% of urban areas have proper sanitation. Over a three-year period, water.org's new commitment will bring safe drinking water and sanitation to a minimum of 50,000 people, helping decrease the prevalence of water and sanitation-related diseases. It'll also enhance awareness of good hygiene practices among local communities and improve water resource management. To achieve this, we will support local NGOs through our grant-driven program, adding new members to our global network of partner organizations. This will deliver subsidies to some of Haiti's poorest communities to enable them to establish sustainable water and sanitation infrastructure. In the longer term, we'll also explore relationships with microfinance partners on the ground to extend water credit to Haiti. Drawing on major donations and grassroots support through a proactive social media campaign, water.org will deliver at least $2 million to fund this commitment, and we're well on our way because of the generous support of the Acre Foundation. But we want to challenge everyone here in this room tonight to support this commitment to the people of Haiti by visiting us at water.org. Thank you very much.
Program at its core, but it's really an empowerment and enablement program.
I liked the initiative in the sense that it was focusing on an area that I'm very passionate about, education.
If you are a very smart girl in Kenya, you do get a terrific government sponsorship to university, but you have to wait 21 months to start. Not only do you want to keep her safe, you also want to keep her mind active. That's when Microsoft came into the picture.
This initiative for Microsoft gives you opportunities we only imagined in our day.
The course that you're doing is so helpful. It's highly marketable. By the time I go to the university, I'm a step ahead.
So we as the Institute girls, we have our give back commitments because we understand the impact that giving to others has on their lives.
This is the place where I give back, clean her house, I wash the utensils, I wash clothes.
I've been going around and collecting clothes and giving to these people who like completely don't have. I'm more focused. Now there's nothing impossible. Yeah, like I believe I can do anything else. I just can't see a bright future for me. I mean, I can't see anything else. I don't think anything can stop me.
Good evening. And thank you, President Clinton, for the extraordinarily brief introduction, which during the UN General Assembly week does not happen at all. I want to acknowledge Bob Harrison and the outstanding work that he's doing as CEO. Deputy Director of CGI for their excellent work. Some of you are aware that last week President Clinton and I were here in New York together. We were having lunch in a small Italian restaurant. And we talked about the economy, we talked about healthcare, we talked about pressing global challenges. And then he said to me, "Will you pass the Parmesan?" And then he said to me, "Would you speak to our annual meeting?" I think everyone knows what it's like when Bill Clinton asks you to make a commitment. He looks you in the eye. He feels your pain.
Around the world, Bill Clinton has helped improve and save the lives